Okay. So, hi everyone. My topic is on the, I think that's a daily basis for the developers, as I am at Virtus Lab. So, short about me, and my presentation should be short because we are running out of time. So, first of all, I'm Scala developer at Virtus Lab and computer science student. Okay, so basically, what kind of stuff we like in Scala and frameworks around the Scala. So we like play, we agree, because it's fast, it's easy to implement everything, and we can do the project in the one night. We like Akka for the same reasons, I think. And also SBT, because SBT is, for me, it's better to see the compile time error rather than parsing error, because I don't understand parsers. I don't know if you understand parsers, but compilers, I do. So what I don't like, okay, so, and we don't like JEE. Enterprise is big and it's fat, and we don't like it. And we don't like XML-based programming, like here. For example, it's a web XML standard for the container running. Okay. My topic is about Apache Camel, which is something taken from the Java Enterprise world, but it's really powerful when you look at it. And we choose it rather than choosing Akka, and we tried different implementations. For example, we tried standard Akka, we tried Akka streams, and at the end the Apache Camel. And why? We have some system requirements for our business. We want to have a system that is reliable, resilient, and we have flexibility in moving things around. And at first glance, Akka is excellent, but one of our requirements is that we want to persist a session with a client that is making a request in order to inform it about status of the transaction. For example, the message that is sending to us is, for example, wrong formatted. It's not a JSON, but it's supposed to be. Or, for example, the endpoint that is sending to, I mean, the endpoint on the other client is doesn't exist. And one thing that I didn't mention, is that we are working on the system that is passing messages between external systems. For example, we have a client A which sends us XML message, which can be business message like order, and we would like to send this order to our system that understands JSON, for example, and we have to parse, we have to transform this message, check it against some business rules, and send it to the endpoint, to our application. We choose a Camel for that, because, for example, Akka Streams doesn't guarantee you that you don't lose a message. And in normal Akka, it was a threat for us that we would have to implement this persistence layer to inform the client that his request is bad. And running futures is not a option, because when you run the future and the timeout is exceeded, the future still is running, but your client is not waiting for that result. So it's not either a result, it's not a good option. So what is Apache Camel? As I said, it's good for message passing. It's integration framework, so it's like Java EE. it supports routing messages. It has great DSL, but not that great at it. Java. It's thread-based. It's not very good, but it's optimized to thread pool to, for example, process message on the same thread, for example, because we want to have a full information about what is happening with message, and has a lots of add-ons. You can plug it to the GMS. You can listen on Netty, for example, or Jetty, or whatever you want. If you want to listen, for example, or RabbitMQ, you just plug the RabbitMQ. So there is this project called Akka Camel, but it's not perfect because it's not well maintained. There are still some bugs. For example, there is bug hanging around about fixing tests. It supports old version of Camel, and only ends of the communication, which I will show later. So let's look at the code, and I will explain. How Camel works. Okay, it's not great, but I think it's okay. So first of all, we want to have some the base thing for Camel is called the processor. It contains some logic, and this logic moves around our messages. This message is called the exchange. It has some. It's like an envelope, for example, and inside this envelope there is this message which contains body. And for example, this processor is particularly for printing out the body. And another thing to mention is that when you there is a lot of mutability, so it's not good for the developers, especially in for Scala developers, because we don't like to mutate the state. And on my path, I have a couple of processors, but they are not relevant for that. Let's take a look at the main part, which is the routing part. Here is how we handle the Camel requests. It's coming from the endpoint, as you can see, it comes from the Jetty endpoint, which is Jetty is written in asynchronous way, so it's pretty fast. And here we have a choice, which basically what it does, it expects a predicate on which we select the processor, the path to go by. And in that case, we select post or get or just another thing, and everything starting up by setting a context, which is here highlighted, and then by starting this context. And this is this looks this example is pretty simple, but to write a test for it, it's pretty nasty, because you have to have a fake endpoint and fake output, and then build a fake path, because in other way you would have to make the exchange object by yourself, and this is not a trivial thing because it's Java. So for everything there is a exchange interface, and for it is an exchange interface impl classes. So it's not so readable. And here's a simple test that expects body in the message and one message received. Okay, but this is a Java thing. Now I want to show you the same thing, written in using a Scala Camel DSL, which is not perfect, but looks almost good. So enter the presentation mode. As you can see, the code is only in one class, but we still have to deal with a mutability, and it's not readable for, because of that. One thing that we get from this DSL, we can pass a simple lambda expressions, Scala lambda expressions. For example, in Java 8, we can also do that, so it's not great. But when you look at it inside, it's poor. It's really poor. Because Ridge Exchange is a proxy class that gives us interface for Exchange, for Java Exchange in Scala. But when you scroll this class, you will see that this is really poor written. It's only a proxy that you can use, but nothing more, especially this class, for example, at the end. So this is far from perfection. And what we tried to achieve when we are working on our project is to write more readable code and to have and to make it more understandable for everyone. So I will show you what we achieved here. So this is base class for our demo. Okay. So it looks almost the same as the previous one. We have some context and we have some route that we execute. And this route is also waiting for Jetty trigger, so it's HTTP request. But there is one thing that is different. It's our implementation of a processor class, which is essential for writing the logic in Apache Camel. And this particular processor is in these four lines of code is getting the message that we are getting from the client and deserializing it to the spray JSON. And as you can see, it is made in generic way that we can pass any kind of our message. So this is not a rocket science. We just did it because we need something to use a camel in a pleasant way. So there is some implicitly JSON reader for a spray JSON. So it's implicitly is just summoning the implicit JSON reader that is context bound here, and we then convert and add the property. So take a look at our exchange. Here is our exchange that we use inside our processor. So this exchange, first thing to notice, it's immutable. It's simple case class. It has typed body. It has also some casting because of the Java internal. The camel is internally built on Java, so we have to use some of casting but it's not a lot. And we can use a, we can add a property for our exchange that is type safe. What I mean by that, we add a property which holds our type, and this type is validated against this property what we want to add. And what the difference is that Camel is working on objects, so we have some type safety for that. And so take a look at our exchange property, and this is the main thing that we are working on to release our project to the open source, because now it's quite coupled with our infrastructure, but we are working on it. So this exchange property is only a placeholder for a type, as you can see, the A plus, which I will clarify in a second, which needs a class tag. And this class tag is now it's only used for a printing printing purposes, but we also use that for finding in HashMap, because you can override a equals and hash code to find not only by name but also by class that is holding in it. And as you can see, our pizza order is the same as the serialized. It has the same key in map that has a deserialized payload, and we can extract this property from the exchange. And what is special about this plus here? Because when you when you're using a library or framework, you don't care about variants, because you are using a your own code base, and you don't think about how others will use your code. But variants here is a pretty powerful thing which we are using, and variants is, I don't know if how many of you know the variance rules in Scala, used variance rules. Okay, so it's half. So basically, for those half that doesn't didn't use the variance, is that when we have a apple that is a subtype of fruit, we are covariant in the meaning that the we are going in the direction of inheritance, and we are covariant when we are going down with the inheritance. And it's pretty powerful when you think about the type, because when you are covariant, your super type for everything is NREF, and when you contravariant, it's nothing. The most bottom type when you want what you achieve is basically. Okay, so last thing that I want to show you to not to is how to test it, because I show you how normal Apache Camel is hard to test, and there is no test framework for Scala DSL. So when you write your own Scala processor using Apache, using Camel Scala DSL library, basically you will have to deal on your own. But when you will use our library, which I soon I expect to release to the open source, you can treat processor as a function, so that you construct your own exchange, which in that case contains a string order, normal JSON, the empty properties, because we don't have any properties, you can set up any property that you want, and then you can unit test it against its logic and check if it contains everything. So one of the last things to show is how it's hidden inside. It's hidden inside just by rewriting things to the to separate into two collections based on this properties map that I shown you previously. And this is the main part that also I'm working on to release this to the open source, because I cannot give you an open source library that holds a fixed map that is taken from the object. It's not good. But I'm working on it, and with my colleagues from Virtus Lab, of course, we are working on it. So we are separating these properties for that we are interested in the context of our application. They are called rich properties, and that we are not interested in, the internal ones. For example, HTTP request headers are hidden here. We don't want to look at it inside our business logic, because it's irrelevant. And then we are calling this abstract method in case of this processor, and the result of it is also an exchange, and we pack everything together and hit the nasty mutability inside. Oops. Okay. So that I tried to be as fast as I could. And do you have any questions for that? Yes. Yes, that was the one of the requirements for us.
What's the other reason? Because I don't see the advantage.
Okay, so basically we wanted to use these guarantees that are very important for us by the meaning of the business rules, because when you miss something in the actor system, for example, some request from the user, it won't harm it. But when you lose an order, for example, for 1 million euros, you will suffer, and that's not acceptable. And also debugging it is pretty simple, because the processors are invoked sequentially, and there is and on the one thread the camel is trying to run it on the one thread pool, so it's pretty simple to debug it. For example, there are fine stack traces that you can analyze from it. You won't be missing anything. Yes, we thought about it, but it was abundant. So we chose the Apache Camel, because you can also integrate with Kafka or with RabbitMQ. So you can listen to. I would say that we have our reasons to do that.
That you want to talk about?
Yes. There are some business rules that we have to hold on, so I cannot be more specific about that. Okay, so thank you very much for staying me that longer.
Thanks, Roderick.